Alright, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So today I talk about the vulva cancer. The global incident of vulva cancer is about 2.4 to 100,000. So the pH is about 64 to 75 years old. So the risk factor that you must know is a lichen sclerosis, about 4 to 7% risk. VIN is a vulva intraepithelium neoplasia, is a multifocal disease, Paget disease, melanoma in situ, smoking and immunosuppression, and advanced maternal age or history of CIN. The etiology still unknown, and then the oncogeny HPV theory and lichen sclerosis theory. Alright. No, so patient may presented during the vulva CA is a first is a pruritus. It's about 71%, and then vulva lump swelling, vulva ulceration because of scratching also, and then bleeding, pain, soreness, and urinary tract infection and discharge. So the histological type you must know about the vulva cancer is right. First is a squamous cell carcinoma. It's about 90% is a malignant, and then metastasis is a local lymph node, and risk of nodal disease varies. And then presentation is a nodule, ulcer and pruritus, soreness and pain and bleeding, offensive smell. Right, that's one, the squamous. And then number two is a varicose or basals and basal cell carcinoma. It's a slow growing warts like lesion with tendency to recur locally after the excisions. And it's a basal cell carcinoma which ulcerated on labia. Okay, 20% will recur. Number three is a adenocarcinoma associated with the Paget disease. It's an extramammary gland. Alright, number four is a malignant melanoma. It's a very poor prognosis. It's a overall survival rate 5 years is about 8 to 50% only. And then in the worsened a melanoma. We have three type of malignant melanoma. First is a mucosal lentiginous, the most common, breast low thickness and amelanosis. Number five is a carcinoma of Bartholin glands. It's a very rare. It either is a squamous or adenocarcinoma or adenocystic carcinoma. More often happen in the young age. During the examination, so we did the VE and the PR examination. So the beta is under examination under anesthesia because it's a pain. The size, location and characteristic of adjacent skin is important, and involvement of vagina and urethra and infiltration. Also, right, because the staging of vulva CA is a surgico-pathological staging. For the first stage is a tumor at the vulva of perineum. So for the 1A, the lesion is less than equal to 2 cm, and stromal invasion is about 1 mm, and then it confined at vulva or perineum region and no nodules metastasis. Right, 1B is a lesion more than 2 cm, and then stromal invasion is more than 1 mm with negative node, right, nodule invasion. Okay, the stage 2, the tumor at any size with the extension to adjacent the perineal structure, means both side adjacent beside that, okay, and with negative nodes, right. So stage 3, tumor with or without extension to adjacent perineal structure with any size, right. So but this time is a positive node, right, positive inguinal femoral nodes, right. If 3A, one lymph node with the size more than 5 mm, or one or two lymph node the size less than 5 mm, right. And then stage 3B is a lymph node is a more than two or more lymph node more than size about 5 mm, and then or more than three is less than 5 mm the size. And then 3C is a positive for extracapsular spread. And then stage 4 is a tumor involved other regional or distant structure. For 4A is involved upper urethral, upper vagina mucosa, bladder mucosa and rectal mucosa. Right. Or any distant which including is a pelvic lymph node. The prognostic factor is in the squamous cell vulva CA is a there is a four criteria you must know. First is nodal status, is the most significant independent factor. So the risk of nodal mass factor involved with the tumor size. If the tumor size less than 2 centimeter, the 2 centimeter, the lymph node involvement is about 23%. 2 to 4 centimeter is about 37%. Right, number two is a depth of invasion. If less than 3 mm, if about 5% only. And then number two, the presence of lymphovascular invasion. And then number three is a stage of disease. Number four is extracapsular spread. Number five is the number of lymph node involvement. Number six, size of lymph node. Because the size less than 5 mm, the survival is about 90%. More than 5 mm, the lymph node involvement is the survival is about 20%. So the management is aim, first is to remove the cancer. Number two is to reduce risk of local recurrence, and then number three is to preserve the function. That's the main aim. So in the early vulva cancer, the major lesions less than 1 to 10 mm in depth. So in depth 1 to 10 mm, the lesions. So we advise for wide local excision because it's a surgical excision must more than 15 mm. 15 mm up, the better is more than 20 mm, so means equal to 2 centimeter in dimension. So if less than 10 mm, the lesions, and then the lesion if more than 10 mm, advice for radical valvectomy, because the risk of local recurrence it depend on the margin of excision. Because if the risk of the lesser margin of excision, the more risk of recurrence. Okay, the study shows if the disease the free margin is more than 8 mm, the risk of local recurrence is about almost equal to 0%. And then if the free margin is about 4 to 8 mm, so the risk of recurrence is about 8%. Then if the risk of margin less than 4 mm, the risk of recurrence is about 54%. Okay, the comparison between radical wide local excision and radical valvectomy, the recurrence rate is more in the radical wide local excision, about 7.2%. Valvectomy is 6.3%. And then advanced vulva cancer. Okay, that's one. In the advanced vulva cancer, wide local excision is more than 15 mm, and radical valvectomy is advisable or all the resection margin. In the young female, we may consider radiotherapy if the surgical fail to local control, and the man is a maximum the local control. So before you proceed, you must know the lymph node status, right? We have a two group of inguinal lymph node, superficial and deep. The superficial one is between camper and cribriform fascia. It's the oblique group and vertical group. In the superficial one, we have oblique and vertical group. And the deep one, we did a cribriform and fascia. And cribriform fascia is in medial to femoral vein, right? So overall survival, if negative node is a 70 to 90%, is high, alright. And then positive node is 25 to 40%. Okay, what happen if we do the complication may happen if we do the groin node dissection. If 50% post-op complication, wound breakdown and lymphoedema, alright. Though for how you want to do lymph node status, first is a clinical palpation. Is inadequate actually, because the sensitivity is about 57% and the specificity about 62% only. Alright, number two is a imaging examination. So it's a groin node assessment. Okay, so MRI have a specificity about 97 to 100%, sensitivity is about 40 to 50%. We can identify clear tissue plane and detail anatomical assessment and assess the depth and tumor extension. Magnetic resonance lymphography is a ultra small oxide iron oxide peroxide is injected intravenous. It improves sensitivity in detection from the 50 sensitivity, because previously MRI is a 50% only. So it improved up to 89%. Okay, the improvement by the lymphography by inject the iron oxide peroxide. Okay. Number 3 is ultrasound. It's a cheap and widely used and less sensitivity. Is the feature is a the feature of ultrasound we can see is a large than 1 cm. If large than 1 cm, is less than 1 cm, we can it's difficult to see. And then loss of oval shape, hypoechoic cortex, loss of echogenic hilar sinus fat, and irregular margin, and increased low attenuation of cortex, and increase the peripheral vascularity on color Doppler. Right. Fine needle aspiration have sensitivity about 58%, but it high risk of sample of error, and difficult to obtain the sample also. And then there is a risk of metastatic spread. Case is highly error. Okay, right. The CT scan have limited role for assessment. And then the PET scan is useful detect the extranodal disease, and but expensive and limited the availability. The sixth one is the sentinel node, not lymphocytography. Okay, what is a sentinel node? The sentinel node is the first node in lymphatic change drain in anatomical area. Right. If the sentinel node is a negative, means all the remaining lymph node will negative also. It's a free disease. First sentinel node inject in the methylene blue dye or into the tumor edge and using this immunohistochemistry. Or we can use tectinium 99 or radio label marker beside that methylene blue. Alright. So second we inject at the margin of lesion. So the result, if negative, no need for nodal dissection, because the risk of recurrence is about 2.3% only. The sensitivity with the tectinium is about 97% and methylene blue is about 95%. Right. We use the gamma probe to detect the tracer. Okay. Tectinium. The surgical treatment actually is a more conservative and surgical management is a more conservative. Actually, our management more to conservative. It's individualized treatment. Alright. So in the early stage, stage 1A, stage 1A means the lesion is less than 2 cm. The invasion is less than 1 mm. So what local incision minimum margin at least is a 10 mm, but it's advisable to do up to 1.5 to 2 cm. Alright, so the optimal, the best one, because what the difficult we may encounter is during the closure. Okay, the more than 2 cm. Right, tumor free margin is important to prediction for local recurrence. Right, routine lymph node is lead to unnecessary procedure in actually PLND, inferior then adjuvant pelvic irradiation. So we advise for this case if there is a lymph node positive, so we do the adjuvant radiotherapy. Okay, so management of lymph node, so it's a 1A. And more than 1B, it require lymph node assessment. If more than 1B, it will require lymph node assessment. So can be done in separate incision. Okay. Radical wide local incision at least 5 mm and free margin. And okay, all right. So actually, in 1B and above, it's a triple incision usually we practice nowadays. And then lymph node management, lymph node mapping is a lymph node mapping in the selection of lymph node mapping. Example, depth invasion is more than 1 mm. Who candidate to primary surgery and possible to inject around the tumor, and no fixed or lymph node in groin, and no enlarge of lymph node during the CT scan. And tumor located in close to midline or less suitable in the higher, because in midline Right. In advanced disease, in local advanced, radical excision or radical vulvectomy with the plastic reconstruction is we did. Okay. Post-op care, the important in the during the post-op care is CBD drain, CBD at least 5 to 7 day, perinatal care and bowel function also involve if involve the anal sphincter and mobilization to prevent the DVT. Primary radical therapy is designed for patient who not fit for surgery or tumor near to vital organ, especially in the clitoris or urethral area. New adjuvant is allowed to for fertility preservation surgery. So adjuvant radiotherapy is indication if positive surgical margin, narrow surgical margin mean that less than 8 mm, an extra capsula or present of lymph node. Role of local regional failure after a reduced. Alright, it's a serve the role of radiotherapy is reduce the local regional failure, local regional recurrence. Okay, and then it reduce the post surgical failure and serve as alternative of PLND. It show is a superior companion PLND, and then it can do before operation also do it for new adjuvant. Okay. Okay. About the radical vulvectomy, we have en bloc and separate or en separate groin incision. Radical vulvectomy with the groin lymph node incision is a single incision, or radical vulvectomy with the groin lymph node incision with triple incision is better in the cosmetic outcome. For triple incision, better in the cosmetic outcome. Regarding the relapse in bridging of tissue left between the vulvectomy and the groin. Okay, this one is a radical vulvectomy and this one is a triple incision. Okay, alright. So I want to show you another type of the radical. Okay, so it's the butterfly incision. This is a longhorn incision. And then this one is a triple incision. This one is the type of the radical vulvectomy also. The modified radical vulvectomy, we have as an anterior hemi vulvectomy and posterior hemi vulvectomy or right hemi vulvectomy. So the longhorn incision sexual dysfunction is about 70% and long term survival about 70% in the 5 year, and then 90% in stage 1. Alright, breakdown is about 50 to 20% if the triple incision. Lymph edema in triple incision is about 30 to 70%. Because why we choose the triple incision is better in the cosmetic outcome and the breakdown also less, and the relapse. Okay, that's all about the vulva CA. Thank you.